Hey team 101, today we will be analyzing and forecasting a market for Bitcoin and gold, for gold and Bitcoin from 3rd till 4th June. So here we can see that the gold has recently touched the lower resistance, lower support which we have drawn. As I have told in my quick update, tomorrow we can take a sell position after the break of this resistance. I have taken a sell position of some around 1728 and closed my sell positions around some around 1713 to 1714 as the market has broken this resistance. Now what we should do is that going on in 4-hourly chart, here what I am expecting the market to do is to bounce off this support zone as the market has tested. Moreover, we can see or draw a resistance zone if it is broken, thus a long position can be created. Here it is drawn a resistance zone. Moreover, we are having an data coming up. The numbers of the data can create a volatility and the market can take a support. Here we can also see that the market recently taken the support of 4 hour of an MA 50 MA, which is in 50 moving average, and bounces off. Here the market is testing this resistance. What I am expecting for the gold to do today and tomorrow is that the gold should test this support zone once more and will go for a long position with here, where the take profit just placed decent highs. Moreover, we can draw our resistance, our support zone. Let me draw it going on in a small time frame of a 2-hourly chart. Here just squeezing. Here let me draw the support zone. From here, till here we can see how the market has been respecting this resistance and our support zone both. As here it has acted as a resistance, here it has acted as a resistance, here also resistance. Here the market has taken the support and we have seen a breakout, thus a move upwards 1763. What I am expecting for the gold to do is that we can expect the market for the gold to test this zone once again and thus will go for a long position. So in summary, what a trader should do for 3rd and 4th June for gold is that I will wait for the gold market to either test this zone or to break this resistance line. If the market has tested this zone, will go for a long position some around 1709 with a take profit just place recent high stop loss of some around below the support zone. Thus this trade will provide a risk to reward of 1 ratio 5.5. That's a great risk to reward. Okay, moreover, if we do not experienced a pullback and we experienced a breakout through this resistance trend line which I have drawn, will go for a long position on a pullback. Take profit would be placed some around below the recent highs and the stop loss would be placed some around below the support zone. This trade will provide a risk to reward of 1 ratio 3. That's not a good risk to reward, but according to the situation it will be a good opportunity to trade. However, what I am expecting and what I am likely to see that the gold should test the support zone, as on usually on Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday we see a bearish move in gold, and on Thursday and Friday we can see a break through this resistance line. Moreover, the month of June is a bullish for gold, as previously we have seen the gold to break the resistance to break the major resistance of 1360 and break through it and testing the 1400 zone. So what I am expecting for the gold is to break this trend line. However, if the gold does not test it, this zone and break this, we can go for a long on pullback. Now going on in Bitcoin, we are currently on a Bitcoin chart for a 2-hourly chart. What I have told in my previous or the yesterday forecast weekly follow up, that we are seeing a bullish pennant and we can see a breakthrough or break downwards or break upwards, and was likely or was what I was expecting for the Bitcoin to do is a bearish move, and the take profit and the stop loss was placed. Thus I take my position some around 10,116, and the Bitcoin just triggered my take profit after 1 or 2 hours. Thus now what we are seeing in Bitcoin is that Bitcoin has done a fake breakout. Going on an higher time frame of a 1 day chart, we can see that the Bitcoin has done a fake breakout. Now what I am expecting for the Bitcoin to do is that we'll go for a long position on a Bitcoin some around this support zone with a take profit and a stop loss as shown. We'll go long on a Bitcoin some around here. If the Bitcoin tested this trade will provide a risk reward of 1:2. Moreover, we can expect the Bitcoin to, rather than not testing the support, rather breaking this resistance zone and continue its bullish move upwards. Thus we can take a long position on a breakthrough of this with our take profit just placed below the resistance, below the recent highs, and the stop loss would be just placed below the resistance zone. This trade will provide a risk to reward of 1:1.8. That's not a good risk to reward, but in this situation it can be carried out. So in the summary, what a trader should do for the Bitcoin for 3rd and 4th June is that what I am expecting for the Bitcoin now is that a bearish move towards the support, go for a long position within take profit just placed below the highs. Moreover, going on a smaller time frame, we can see that Bitcoin is making a bullish flag pattern, a bearish flag pattern from here till here. Thus for scalping or taking a short term trade, if the Bitcoin break through this support zone, this resistance zone, thus a long position can be created. However, what I am expecting for the Bitcoin is to do for a short term to test this resistance which it has been testing recently, and to a downwards move towards here. Thus a sale position can be created over some around 9600 will then take profit of 9500. However, I will not trade this scenario, rather I will trade a long position some around the test of support, or rather either the Bitcoin breaking this. Any fundamental news changing the direction of the market for gold or Bitcoin, I will update the next trade opportunities giving by the market in my quick update if there is a change in the momentum of what we are expecting. Thanks for watching. If you do like my analysis, do like, share and comment below, and do consider subscribing, as in 2 to 3 days I will be posting a a summary of three stocks which I have recently added in my portfolio, which is in recession proof or to hedge my losses. Thanks for watching.